My topic is on urban forestry and corporate funding. Just to give you a little bit of background about how I came about this project, is India was the first country 2 years ago to pass a law stating that companies which were earning over a certain net profit had to, by law, assign 2% of their profits towards any social cause. And as you know, India is a very economically diverse and struggling country. Most of the funding goes towards poverty or human causes, and I wanted to see what leverage I can get to get some of these funds towards urban forestry. So I'm from Mumbai on the west coast there. We have about 20 million people and green cover, which is less than 16%. This amounts to less than half a tree per person. So you can imagine the density and the pollution with all the environmental disasters. The need for urban forestry is really quite significant. Mumbai falls in a very ecologically sensitive zone called the Western Ghats. We have over 300 endemic species which are globally threatened, and it's a very ecologically sensitive hotspot. We have one national park on the outside, outskirts of Mumbai, which, because we don't have any green zones or green belts, because of city expansion and population pressures, it's completely encapsulated this one remaining national park. So for my project here, I wanted to look at one interesting and innovative projects regarding urban forestry, and second, to look at innovative funding to leverage on corporate funding. Because corporate funding and CSR shouldn't just be about social image, it should also have some sort of return on investment for the corporate sector. So that way they would be more incentivized to invest in it for the longer term, and this would make sure that projects in urban forestry have a higher lifetime. So some of the topics that I've been looking at are CSR funding, certification, and this has become one of my new interests in the last 6 months, which are carbon and water quality credits. I'll just give you a brief snapshot of four projects that I really liked. One of them has been the Clackamas County Urban Timber Project. Dave is sitting right there. He's the mastermind of this. So I'm going to sneak a little bit of his ideas. Every year in Portland, nearly 20,000 board feet of urban timber is wasted, and most of it goes towards pulp and paper, and the remaining is just discarded. So strategic planning and plantation of tree species which have high carbon sequestration are climate change resistant, and efficiently planning these trees can be very productive in terms of environmental benefits as well as financial incentives. Coupling these with other projects such as carbon credits. Carbon credits and urban forestry is a new upcoming topic in the US. And Mark McPherson, who's one of the pioneers of this, he hopes to roll out the urban forestry carbon project next year. So taking different elements from Portland and the Pacific Northwest and coupling these can come up with a very strong project that can be adopted by different corporate sectors such as Nike. I won't go too much into the science, but just to give you an idea of the value of urban forests, in America alone, urban forests are valued at over $2 billion. Some of the other projects that I've looked at have been poplar and pea fixing families in brownfields. In India, in the heart of cities, we have a lot of these waste areas, which we call wastelands, which are essentially dumping grounds. They have low commercial and real estate value. Companies in residential areas don't want the burden of remediating this area or purchasing this land. The government has very low funds to be in charge of these areas. However, working with conservancies and corporate sectors to invest in these areas, there can be a huge possibility. One of the last projects that I'll point towards is riparian planting. Sometimes we look at industrial or mechanical solutions, but all you need is to go back to nature, and simple solutions have the highest benefits and the lowest cost. So a simple thing such as riparian planting can have cost savings of over $150 million. So you can imagine the impact that these projects can have. In terms of tools and citizen action, I think the community presence in cities is much stronger and involvement is much higher as well. So engaging the community to use open source tools to contribute, to have researchers band together to provide good research can make sure that there is a lot of knowledge about urban forestry which is coming together and is not just at the research level but is actually being applied by corporate sectors. I've also looked at some of the design and technology and using biomimicry. You've probably seen a lot of these tree vaults when you walk around Portland. So there's a lot of inspiration in the Pacific Northwest that I hope to take a little bit of each of these design ideas and market mechanisms, and hopefully in the future, we're a long way behind carbon markets in India or even in Asia, but hopefully at some point using some of these methods would come up with a good model that can be replicated around cities in India. So the whole idea behind this is to make a shift towards for-profit conservation so that the corporate sector and the environmental sector can both be winners. Looking at urban heat island, which is one of our biggest problems, we have very severe monsoon and drought problems coming back to back in India. So urban forestry can actually be a huge mitigation factor in solving some of these problems. And hopefully this can also inspire a sort of forest legacy in urban forests and get the corporate sector to be involved in long-term sustainability and long-term development. So that's a little brief, you know, introduction to what I've learned in the Northwest and a background to my interests. So thank you.